This talk is about LibreGraphics and teaching and certificating. I'm not a teacher. I'm active in the documentation of and support of the Scribus. But I've had some contact with several teachers now, and I feel that there is a need to have more exchange between teachers in the LibreGraphics. So I'm presenting to the developers on one side, and eventually on people doing some graphics courses, how the teachers could interact to have better teaching experience, help from other people, exchange. One question, is there any teacher here or people doing courses? Okay, several, it's good. What I've noticed is that teachers feel alone. We have documentation for software, which most of the time is in English, but teachers have to give their courses in their own language. So they can't take much material in English if they're not in America, England, or Australia. Most of the time, teachers are a bit alone in their school. Maybe one teacher who does graphics in one school. So it hasn't much exchange with other teachers. And if there are any other teacher which do similar subjects, it's probably that they don't care about free software. So they may be against you if you try to teach free software in graphics skill in free software. Things are changing. In Alto Adige, in Italy, the region is pushing somehow free software. They are asking for teachers giving GIMP, Scribus, and Inkscape lessons in public schools. They are paying for, for teaching to people who are unemployed, new skill with free software. And there are also some private school which offer free graphics lessons. I've contacted with somebody in Lokeren in Belgium who also teach in a school where several teachers are free software friendly. They are teaching Linux skills, but also free graphics already now. What I noticed is that there are some pressure on companies and on school and on public sector to use more free software to do some economies, because they don't have as much money for software which they don't use as much. It's not, most of the time, not a core software, core feature for them, graphics. So they don't want to spend too much for graphics. There are some teachers which are around. One is here, is Cedric, who is offering, already done a big list of different courses. How do you say un cours in English? It's courses, it's right. Okay. Yeah, many courses. I don't know how many of you already know this, or how many of you can point to him if somebody asks. I think not many. It's not well known. This is a private school in Italy, which is offering a DTP course in with Scribus. But everybody doing this work are very alone. It's not well known what they are doing. Maybe with the exception of Cedric, which is very active in the whole community. And the result is a lot of duplicated work, which often of lower quality as what could have been done, because they have always to start from zero. The school's pupils don't see really what their interest is to learn it, because they don't see it around them. So they learn Scribus, but everybody else learns InDesign. What they can do with it, they don't know it. Often tutorials are built for one specific version for one platform, so they're not reusable. When somebody else does another course, they can't really use it. And since you have to start from zero, you concentrate most of the time on explaining the software, and you don't have the full vision, which will enable you to teach well graphics with real software. That is, you learn skills which you can use with any program afterwards. Okay. So an example is here. We have been told yesterday about the Scribus book. I think no teacher can use this. It's a good work, but you can't build your course on top of it. I have a nice example. What is the alternative? This is from Vanessa Callebeau in Belgium. She has done 150 pages manual tutorial on graphics and Scribus. It's a huge work. Nobody knows that she has done it. She has no platform to exchange on it. It's a real well-done work. She's alone. Even people from Belgium speaking her language didn't know it. So I think the need is to be faster, easier to produce something like this, and to let the other people know that there is something like this. She's ready to share it. So the question is, yes? She asked several questions on the mailing list when writing her manual. I knew it. So I've learned about it through the mailing list. And I've met her now, and we talked about it, about plans, what we can do for the future. So maybe it's important. I know about three teachers which are really active. One is Lorena Colme in Italy, Vanessa Callebeau in Belgium, and Cedric Jamy in France, which write in three different languages. And they can't really talk to each other because they speak different languages. They're not comfortable enough in English, with the exception of one of them. And So for the teaching part, for me, there are two big questions. Why share, what to share, and how to share. I think why, a part of it, I've already said it. Each teacher will have his reasons why he wants to do it. But I think there is really an interest to do it. What to share? I think sharing everything is not an option for most teachers. But depending on the teacher, they're willing to share their table of contents for the manuals, which is already a big improvement, a screenshot set. You maybe will be able to reuse them, or just you know what screenshots you have to do, which is already much easier. Lessons plan, what to teach, how, and when, without much details. Exercises, some people will be ready to share them, some people not. Tutorials, there's full tutorials like this. She's ready to share it. She's not ready to share her exercises as to now. On the other side, Lorena will be ready to share her exercise. So it's very different from person to person. For this to happen, I think the best way, since they're a bit everywhere in the world, at least in Europe, is to have a web platform where we could share this. We should build it, probably. Another thing which would help to create a community is to have a certification for teachers So you know who are the teachers, you know what level they are, have, and maybe create a list, with this create a list of teachers and courses so that all this is public. Mostly from Italy, I hear a big need for certification. On the one side, it's clear you want just have it to get a job, but it's also to give to the pupils that they get something. I don't think it will be an easy task because Libre Graphics, Free Graphics is a huge domain. I've looked a bit. I've seen three certification programs which somehow are similar. The one is the Blender certification, which I don't exactly know, but I've seen that it's quite specifically well-defined on their website. I would be interested if somebody is here. You are from there. I would be interested in talking with you a bit from experience. It will be a the big difference will be that Blender has already an organization behind which can handle it. We don't have it. So another one is the Open Office certification program, which is more similar to what I think about because it's about several skills. You have a database, a spreadsheet, write, and drawing, which about will fit also our needs with several programs. And what I know about a bit is the LP certification, which is well spread. You will get many chances to be certified on different levels in a very loose way. You can go to a conference and get certificated there, which would be an easy way, easier than to travel to Holland or Belgium and get a certificate in Blender. So what is about the goal? We have to certificate knowledges, giving better chance when applying for a job, giving some reward for having learned, so people know they have done something. Give a more serious image to the graphic software. It's not because you're certified that you're better, but if there is a certification, the software is already better. It's in a certification program. It's more interesting. It will help spreading the free software in the schools because there will be a frame around it, and people think it's cool to be Libre Graphics certificated. Three possible goals, more specific. One is certified teachers, who is a real teacher. Certified graphic artists, so they can put a paper more on their resume, and maybe what for me is less important, for users which do a course that they have a small paper saying, I made it. There will be three different levels. How to do it? We should define which certificate we would issue, define how it would work. I think that the Blender way is quite a good way. You have to send in a resume, some works you have done, and so on. And found an organization which will issue the certificate. My wish is to find a company or an organization which already exists, which will handle this, if it's possible. Why not the Blender Association? Something which will be broader in graphics, if something exists, would be very nice. Also for the name, it would be already there. Yes?
In examples, there are also a PHP and MySQL certification. And I know the guy in France who does the PHP certification. I often work with them. So maybe they could help to organize it and to give a place to make it. Yeah.
Yes. So very welcome input. Well, we are to the last slide. It's still en chantier, so We have no result yet. And I have, for big questions, what people like you would like to share among teachers. One big question is how to manage the many languages so that it doesn't get too complicated and still you can build upon a standard work. Who should issue a certificate and what should be certificated? And since we are in the free world, here are where I took the pictures from. Since they're CC BY, it's their work. Well, if there are some questions, they are really welcome. Otherwise, okay.
It's not really a question, it's more of a comment. But there is, do you know WASP, the open the web standards project, the wasp.org? No. It's an open web standards organization. It's a they do. Have you heard of the ACID tests? They did the ACID tests. They started the ACID tests.
Do I know them?
The WASP and several other companies and several companies have come to W3C and are trying to start an open with something called OWEA, the Open Web Education Alliance, and this is a this is an attempt. This goes beyond graphics, but it's an attempt to make a standardized curriculum and a set of lesson plans for for web development, and part of that could be web graphics, that is part of the plan. Obviously, there'll be companies like Adobe that want to publish their materials for their products, but then there are also companies, there's also a place for free software, and this is not an attempt at certification. It's just an attempt at creating a curriculum to make teaching materials that teachers can use. So it'd be very interesting to talk to you in that context later.
Definitely. Thank you.
So I haven't taught high school for 12-ish years, so this may be all out of date. But one of the issues that we had in Ontario when we were reviving the technical curriculum in high schools was...
A bit louder.
Sorry. One of the issues we had in Ontario revising the technical curriculum for high schools was you'll set up a shop or something, so it could be a graphics laboratory, and the stuff is expensive and it quickly goes out of date, and school can't afford to buy all new software every time they have a version change. So the philosophy that we were developing in Ontario at the time was called broad-based technology, and the focus was on what was called generic skills. And so you wouldn't train students, for instance, on Word or Photoshop per se. You'd train them on the generic skills that could be moved. So when the student got out into the working world, they would have learned, for instance, a topic might be a mask, right? So applying a mask to an image, right? And so they wouldn't have learned about the mask in a Photoshop context. They would have just learned about mask, right? Mask was the big issue. And then how you do it in Photoshop or CorelDRAW, that was kind of subsidiary, right? So if you want to attract teachers, one of the issues that you're going to face is people will say, well, why should I train students in the GIMP? None of the local employers use the GIMP, so it would be wasted training. And so then the magic word is generic skills, right? And so if you focus on that, then that gets you around, like nobody uses this in the real world. You just say, that's your mantra, generic skills, right? And then you can say, you know, this stuff is cheap. We can get the latest version every year. Every time they update it, we can get it. It's free. and we're teaching generic skills, and the students will always be up to date. Okay. The other thing is, if you want a supply of teachers to run things past, there's the Moodle community. So it's spelled M-O-O-D-L-E. It's Moodle is a courseware. It's an open source courseware. And there's lots and lots of uptake. I think locally Concordia is using it. And you know, they have a long, long list of schools all over the world that are using Moodle. And so if you go on the Moodle site, and you should be able to find people who are interested in what you're interested in, and you may even find people who have already developed curriculum.
I will shortly answer.
One thing I would add that I didn't mention.
Moment, please.
Excuse me.
So on the one side, clearly, generic skills, if is for me a goal there, that's why I want to centralize that people can concentrate on that part of teaching and not on the exact what button to click when. I think if you share your documents, they will go up in the level in the generic skills. That's really a goal for me. About Moodle, I know about it. It's a broad framework. I didn't want until now to get much input. I chose some people to ask to. Then it was this community to ask. It's also a goal that there is a broader, as soon we have a website, as an example, we have to have a place where the people can contact us. And then I will contact a broader community like the Moodle one. It was not possible until now because I don't have the middle to use the input afterwards. So it's useless to have much input, which I can work on it. But I've noticed it, and I will do it. Okay.
I would just say that didn't mention it yesterday. One of our ambitions, and I guess one ambition leads to more ambitions, is when we are coming out with the second edition of our manual, we would like to be able to publish it simultaneously in English, French, and German, perhaps other languages. I know places like Brazil have a huge interest in open software. So, you know, it's a matter of getting the translators online as the book is being created, because we found that if we waited until the book was totally done and then tried to translate, that work is massive. You have to get people online as the book is being created. Where you're at the wiki stage, and you can be translating articles on the fly, so that then when you get to the assembly part of the book, the layout, then you've got a job that sort of can keep everything together and not have this cascading time frame. So, and I think we are in better shape of understanding where the glitches are in the process to try to shorten the development of the book as well. So I think that's going to help things like this. The book, of course, is a reference manual. It's not a tutorial. It's not a textbook for the classroom. But it's a place where the teacher can go, using the teacher's knowledge and skills, to take that information and decide what the coursework is going to be. What are the projects that we're going to put together? What do we need to do that?
Definitely. One problem which I didn't mention is a license problem. We wanted to translate the Scribus book in Italian. We have not managed because of license problems. So this is a big issue. I don't know of any license which will fit for courseware really in a perfect way, because people don't want other people to just grab their work and use it one-to-one. But you still want to be able to use it commercially, because for me, a school is a commercial entity, and it gets more and more commercial. Mostly if you have a private school, if you're teaching in a private school, it's commercial.
Could you possibly devise some sort of document language where I reserve...
Could you have some sort of documentation license where the author reserves the rights to the document only in the original language, but allows translations in other allows other people to claim other languages?
it will be possible. I've looked at several several licenses which exist. I know GPL very well. I know the CC license, Creative Commons license, quite well. So I know license, but I don't see one which fits really for that problem. Maybe I don't see it. It's possible. This is also something I want to talk to people. For the scribble, for translating this, the problem was that you can't use it commercially. You can't print a book in Italian if you use the English text. And I wanted to, nobody wants to print a book now, but it will be a group translation. So I have to know now under which condition I maybe will be able to print it. Because maybe in the future comes somebody and wants to print it, and we have five people who have translated the book, and from the scribe's team comes the condition we have to do this and this, and the people translating won't accept it, one of them maybe, and then I have a problem. So that's a bit, if scribe's, it's not a bad license in there, but it restricts publishing it as a book, and I couldn't handle with Christoph Shep, with Christoph how we will be able to print it. So it's dead.
Well, authors might also be worried about the accuracy of translations. Because I find a lot of errors, even not understanding the languages very well. I find lots of mistakes in the translation of my documentation, and there's a constant back and forth as to how to get it right. Yeah. But that's just for a man page. For something the size of a book, I can't imagine.
For me, it's an open question, and I don't have any solution.
Yes, it's true that the quality is a problem. That's why the certification could be interesting too, because when a teacher or when a user is certificated, you can assume he's good and he can understand, he's precise, etc. About the language problem and the license, it is sure that when you teach a software, the student want to go back with some documentation in his pocket, you know? So there will be a need. There is actually now, right now, a need to print documentation. So if the scriber's manual license don't allow it, that's a problem. Okay. But actually, what I can say with my experience is that when there's a book, for example, mine about GIMP or Inkscape, I know many other teachers that use it, print it or copy it, and it's not on the free license. So.
I can tell about a single problem I had with it from Italy. The manual would have been translated in Perse in Italian for a specific course founded by the EU, European Union, and the condition was that the EU may want to print it. So it's not internally the course, it's more, and then it failed. So that was the framework where it happened. One of the three.
So with this scribe's manual license question, I mean, that when people license things under, you know, kind of Creative Commons non-commercial licenses, then they're typically just saying, like, I'm not licensing this for commercial uses completely freely, but here's my contact details. You know, if you want to do something which the license doesn't allow, then I'm probably going to be open to licensing it in some other way, which is quite different to, you know, the typical, like, all rights reserved, get lost.
I agree.
Approach, right?
This works very, very well when somebody translates it. But when it's a team translating it, when you maybe don't know anymore who has done some parts of translation, when you do it over a wiki, as an example, you have to give clear rules. You can't say, we translate it now, and if we do it commercially afterwards, we will see what we do. I want to have clear rules from the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
That's the problem. It's clear when I translate a full book, it's no problem contacting you and asking you, giving you money for, it's really not a problem, not an issue for me.
Mm-hmm.
It's good, but it's a problem when you have a team doing the work.
Yeah, I mean, I think that things can be slightly more informal, potentially.
But
it depends always on the individuals involved. But yeah, I mean, if I wrote some documentation, and
if I translate this,
doing this,
I don't know the people who are translating it. I've never met none of them who will be involved here.
Yeah.
So I can't say if they agree on what they would agree or not.
Mm-hmm.
I have much contact with which one would have done it, but the other ones, I really don't know who they are. So mm-hmm. It's difficult.
Yeah.
One question?
I was a science teacher before, a high school science teacher, and I was an educational advisor also in the school district. So just a quick comment about the initiative and where you want to go. Teaching is really a personal act. It's not something when you take something and you redo it the same way. I've never met a teacher who took a manual, a textbook, even a tutorial or a learning activity and did it the same way as it was intended by the people who wrote it. So this, I think, is the first thing people have to keep in mind when they do certification or they do learning programs for others to go. So the necessity to have a platform to exchange content is important, but what you have to keep in mind is that all teacher, science, math, or graphic, or any kind of teaching you will do, you'll need to remix your things. You'll need to be able to scrap a bunch of things or to copy things, and the open licenses permits that, so that's handy. The problem with all the platforms like Moodle and Wikis and all those kind of things is that the teacher needs to have the liberty to do so, but the ease of usage, if you wish. So even if you, for example, you would say, well, teachers are not going to use that reference book for Scribus. Well, they will, but they will use it to create a four-pager that they will distribute to their students and with which they will work with afterwards. And probably if you did a four-pager for them to do an activity, probably they won't use your four-pager. They will do a fifth-page thing with something they added themselves. So just keeping that in mind, I think it's some issues and some activities and initiatives of people will shine up and say, well, we're going the wrong way because doing this, we tell teachers what to do. And that's not the way a teacher work normally. So.
The answer is table of content. I wish to have a table of content where a teacher can go, see what other people have done, and build upon it their work. That's, for me, a very important part, more than having a text already written, because it's much easier if you already see what you could do, if you can mix them, table of contents. The second one is screenshots, which is also a task which takes much work. If you already see what other people have done a screenshot, we will help you. The idea is to give raw material, which will help you, and maybe also already done tutorials. But the other two are, for me, more important. Voilà. Thank you. Thank you very much. One more.
So we spoke yesterday a little bit about Scribus, and having a foundation, having something available to do like a certification program. So how much of a hindrance is that to moving forward? How much of a problem is that not having an organization to push a certification program through? How much of that is a problem, and how do you think that, you know, how important is that on the scale of getting something like that in place to do?
I think for certification, we need an organization somewhere. We can't do it without an organization. We have somebody who signs.
Do you think that it's not just something that's specific to Scribus, or you know, the Blender has their certification program. Is there something that needs to be created that's for all, you know, Libre graphics? Is there something that one organization that can be done to do the certifications for all the different things?
So Blender is a special case for me because it doesn't integrate much with the other software. The other three, if you want to use it professionally, you have to use GIMP, Inkscape, and Scribus. The idea will be not to certificate GIMP, Scribus, or Inkscape, but it will be even maybe easier to certificate the all together.
Okay.
It's about probably about this. So I don't think we should put in Blender. Maybe for, as an organization, it's for me okay, but I don't see a certification for every single program. I see more of a general certification in graphics because you learn GIMP and then what you do it with it.
Since these are publishing tools, why not say, well, if you can use these tools to create a pretty nice looking certificate, you're qualified.
So I have one last comment. So
you'll be founding certificated. If you give it to us, a nice certificate. No,
it's
maybe I will be open to other content, but yes, it's a good idea.
So a couple of comments or maybe recommendations. So one, yeah, Blender Institute's done a great job making it into a business. So go for it, get some money and make a business out of it, and do it well. And the other thing is Creative Commons has that a unit called Creative Commons CC Learn that handles this type of thing and giving recommendations. So I would recommend that you talk with the project lead of that because there's a lot of kind of specifications for that. That's for everybody too. And then also on the licensing side, giving recommendations for that because there's ample licenses. That's not what's needed. What's needed is to get this up and running and to have some kind of sustainable infrastructure to make it real, in my opinion.
Yeah.
So,
I already have much contact with the Creative Commons Switzerland. So I'm the organization which handles Creative Commons for for Switzerland. Well, thank you very much.
Super.
It's very
thank
useful.
You.
And I'm open to further. Here is my address, and we will try to have something like this. Website for
and
more information.
Add a P on the Libre Graphics meeting. But that's okay.
It won't be maybe that address.
Okay,
thank you very much.